7 biggest mistakes you are making with your product launches. Are you making these mistakes with your product launches? And if you are, this might be why you are not having the success that you desire. We've all been there. Anyone who has done several launches will tell you that they don't always go to plan. I have been running online businesses for over 10 years now, and I have had my fair share of disastrous launches. From every launch failure comes a learning opportunity, and I want to share what learning lessons I've had from all of my launch failures to help you shortcut your success and avoid making the same mistakes over and over again. Today you will discover the biggest mistakes you are making with your product launches and how to learn lessons from your failures to avoid making the same mistakes over and over again. My name is Kath Kyle and I lead the Hustle Less, Manifest More movement. So let me ask you, what mistakes have you learned with your launches and what would you do differently next time? Let me know by leaving a comment on my blog, YouTube channel, or send me a DM on Instagram at Kath_Kyle. So here are the 7 biggest mistakes that you are making with your product launches. These are the biggest mistakes I've made myself over the years and the biggest mistakes that I see other people making over and over again. Number 1. You don't really believe that you will get the success that you want. So let's start with the most important mistake first. You don't actually believe that you can hit your goals. Or maybe you don't even have goals, and that will be mistake number 2. So how many times have you written down your income goals? Have you ever wanted to make $10,000 a month? And that is a pretty common income milestone that most entrepreneurs want to hit when they first start their businesses. And if I asked you what your income goal is, and then asked you if you truly believed that you are going to achieve that this month, more times than not, you'd probably say no. And when I ask people why they don't actually believe that they will get the results that they want, they say a range of answers, such as, I don't actually know how it can happen. I don't have a plan for that to happen. My audience is too small. I don't have enough followers. I don't believe that I'm the kind of person who gets that kind of success. I'm not worthy enough. I'm not as good as other people in my niche. And this is the main reason why you haven't been successful, because your belief system is everything. So take a good look at your reasons why you can't hit your goal and ask yourself, is it actually true? Are there other people who don't have these things and are still having successful launches? Can you let go of the disbelief so that you can choose to believe in your own success instead? And this is absolutely critical. You need to get this before you get anything else when it comes to getting success from your business. Mistake number 2, you haven't decided what results you want to get. So we need to backtrack a little bit. If you don't know what results you want, how will you ever know when you've achieved them? It's critical that you make decisions in your business, and deciding on what your success looks like is one of the biggest decisions that you need to make. So don't shy away from setting goals, even if you've struggled with hitting goals in the past. Let me let you into a little secret. Everyone fails to hit their goals at some point in their business and their life. It's just that most people don't tell you the truth. The truth is that you need to expect failure to hit your goals. You need to expect challenges. You should actually welcome challenges, because things would be boring if you achieved your results too quickly, and it strengthens you as a business owner. So it's time to embrace goals and actually set them. What is the point of setting goals if we don't achieve them most of the time? Because eventually we do achieve our goals, and that is such a fantastic feeling. And you won't achieve any goals if you don't set them first. And I'm going to show you exactly how to set goals for your business the right way. So if you want to watch my goal setting masterclass to understand the three goals that every entrepreneur needs to set, you can go to kathkyle.com/goals workshop. Mistake number three, you didn't realize it is possible to get better results without stress and overwork. So one of the myths that has spread like wildfire and is now adopted as the truth, that is, launches are stressful and time consuming. And I used to buy into this lie, but now thankfully I have found a better way. Most people do find launches stressful and time consuming. Yes, that is true, because they have been told that this is the case. So it is true for them. But it does not have to be true for everyone. And I used to run myself into the ground during my launches, but I now have systems that I plug my new products into and press play and out pops a launch. And it really does feel as simple as that. And I find launching really fun. I'm actually right in the middle of a launch right now, and right now I'm chilling out, creating content in my lovely, comfortable home, and life couldn't be easier. Nothing stressful about this at all. I will not work overtime, I don't work evenings or weekends, and I stick to my healthy habits like glue because I remind myself that there are several things that are important to me every day, and my business is one of them, but so is family. So is my health, so is fun, so is spending time in nature. So I always prioritize every single one of these without fail when I'm launching and also when I'm not launching. I have learned my lessons the hard way and I'm not going to make these mistakes again. Mistake number four, you didn't realize that launching could actually be fun and easy. It seems like every entrepreneur that I listen to tells me that running a business is hard, and anyone that tells you otherwise is lying. And I hear this so often, and it actually makes my blood boil a little bit, because I actually believe that running a business is easy, and I am not lying. So let's look at the word hard for a minute. Can one person perform a task and find it easy? Yes. And can another person perform that same task and find it hard? Yes, of course. So the word hard is subjective, meaning it is based entirely on opinion. And everything that is based entirely on opinion can easily be changed with a simple decision. If you simply decide that from now on business is easy, then it simply is easy for you. It's not true that everyone will find it easy just because you do, but you can choose what is easy and what is hard in your own life. So have I ever had challenges in my business? Yes, of course I have. And despite these challenges, I still choose to say that business is easy, because my measure of what is easy and hard in my life often comes down to whether or not I feel physical pain, and that's my own measure of hard. I find sitting at a computer, typing words and talking with my mouth one of the easiest things that my body can do. Therefore, to me, the act of running a business is easy. And yes, most of us don't run online businesses with our bodies, we run them with our minds. So do I find running a business mentally tough? I personally don't find mental challenges hard. I find them fun, like a mental puzzle that needs to be solved. So when you're playing games, say, for example, your children might play video games, and if you ask them, "Do you play that? Why do you play that? Do you find it hard?" And they might say, "Well, it's a challenge, or it's fun," but it doesn't mean to say that they haven't had to overcome obstacles, but they wouldn't choose to play something if they found it hard all of the time. And that's what I think about businesses. So therefore, I declare that business and also launches are fun and easy for me. And I encourage you to do the same. Mistake number five, you didn't get everything ready in advance. So do you know what makes launching so stressful most of the time? Failure to get everything ready in advance. Even if you are a last minute kind of person, you must admit that this creates a lot of stress living life this way, and having things done in advance is always way more relaxing. A lot of the gurus will tell you to create minimal viable products when you create your whole product live for your first group of students, or you create your marketing materials live on the fly just by doing live streams based on what you feel like on that particular day. So it is true that some people do seem to thrive just by pitching up and doing what they do, but that isn't true for most people. The truth is that those people who just turn up and make their live streams look effortless without planning what they're going to say first have actually been practicing this stuff for a very long time. For those who are new to running a business, it's almost impossible to just turn up for a live stream and not get stressed talking without having prepared it in advance. And in time, you do get more confident just by talking around your subject of expertise because you've been doing it for years. But like anything else, it takes a massive amount of practice. And yes, you will get there, but I don't advise starting this way. What I do suggest you do is start by planning things in advance. Plan out what you are going to create content on. And start by creating a blog post or an outline of what you're going to talk about, and then try recording videos just to get yourself comfortable and used to being in front of a camera. And then maybe progress to doing live streams on the same subject that you've already created content on. And this is the way to build up your confidence. Preparation and practice is the key to having stress-free launches. The more you plan in advance, the easier your launch is going to be. And I prepare literally everything in advance, and that's why I never get stressed during my launches. I am so relaxed, I barely notice that I am launching, and I am launching all of the time, so it just feels very normal to me now. Mistake number 6, you are making your results mean something about you and your business. Have you ever had a failed launch and got so upset about it that you decided you would never do launching again? And I have totally been there myself, and I know that this is very common and it's totally understandable. And most people see launching as such a massive thing to happen, and if big things don't go very well, people get very upset about them. So it can be very traumatic to build up to a big event and not have it go the way you want it to. You can end up feeling like you're just not very good at running a business and you're not very good at helping people, or that you're a complete failure. Instead, why not make your launches a lot smaller in terms of how important they are? When you see your launches as smaller and more normal, you won't make the results mean anything about you. Let's look at something else to use as an example. Say, for example, you like running. I also like running. I wouldn't say I'm a great runner, but I do it on a regular basis. So say, for example, you go for a daily run and sometimes you complete your 5K run in 30 minutes and other days it takes you 35 minutes to do the same distance. Most people don't get overly bothered by this. They just see it as the ups and downs of life. And as long as they generally improve over time, they aren't too bothered about each run. Some days they might not complete their run at all, but they just get up the next day and just do it again. But say, for example, that you run a marathon once a year. You end up running this year's marathon 30 minutes slower than last year. You would probably not see this as a general up and down of life, but instead would wonder what went so badly wrong. And I want you to take the same approach to your launches as you would do to your daily runs. If you do them much more often and make them much smaller, then you won't be as concerned about your results. You won't make it mean anything, and you'll be able to take a much more subjective look at how to improve your next launch rather than getting overly emotional. And when you are new to the world of launches, don't try and copy the gurus by doing just one launch each year. You'll end up putting far too much emphasis on making that a success, and you'll get far too attached to it. Instead, I suggest doing much smaller launches on a much more regular basis, either by creating more smaller products or by repeating the same launch to new people. Mistake number 7, you didn't realize that failure always has to come before success. If you gave up doing launches after one failed launch, you have failed to see that failure always comes before success. So what is a launch failure? I would say that a launch failure is a failure to make any money at all, or spending more money than you made, or the effects of the launch having a negative effect on your business or your life. And I know we talk about launch failure, but I don't like the word failure. I prefer to talk about challenges or just state the facts. So what does failure mean anyway? Failure is just another one of these subjective words that means different things to different people. I don't define a launch as a failure if I sold one product to one person, but there are plenty of people out there who would not agree with me. Therefore, it's a good idea to first of all define what you mean by failure, and then ask yourself if it's really true. For example, you might say that failure to you is making anything under 10k from a launch. And then I would ask you that, say for example, if you made $9,999, would that still be a failure because it's slightly under the 10k that you wanted, that you set for a goal? And you'd probably say no. And that's why it's not a good idea to use the word failure and just talk in terms of facts instead. It is a fact that you spent more money than you made. It's not a failure, just a fact. It's also a learning experience. So what have you learned from this? What consequences does that have? What can you do about the situation now? Is there any way that you can recover some of this loss? Perhaps you didn't sell any products at all during your launch. This is a fact. And what can you learn from this? How can you improve for next time? What would you say to a friend if that happened to them? It's all very normal to have at least one launch where you didn't make any sales at all. So just bear that in mind. And for those people who always made sales right from their very first launch, all that tells me is that those people started launching too late. If they had launched earlier on in their businesses, they would have made more money or had more experience that they could have used to improve future launches. If you start a business with the attitude of acting the way that you would act if you were already successful, that means that you would start launching straight away because it gives you the practice. It's better to test out mistakes when you have a small audience rather than a bigger audience. And even if you have no email list to launch to, I still encourage you to launch because you will create your launch assets and these are part of your system that you will use over and over again. And when you are much busier with clients, you won't have to worry about creating your launch assets. So getting no results at launching should be welcomed as it is helping you practice and saving you time in the future. So I am just curious, have you ever had a failed launch? Do you like the word failure? Do you use it very often? What do you think of the word failure? And I have been there myself and even had one disastrous launch that landed me with such severe health problems that I couldn't move for 6 months. I couldn't work, look after my kids or any of that. So I was too scared to launch again for a very long time. But then I finally discovered a strategy that helped me to launch quickly and easily and actually have fun in the process. And I have documented my system for launching with confidence and ease in my new course called Manifest Your Dream Launch. And I take you on a 30-day journey from planning your dream launch, manifesting your results, launching with fun and ease, and then analyzing your results and planning your next launches. And you can get that by going to kathkyle.com/launch. Make sure you don't miss my next podcast episode by subscribing to my podcast, Manifest Business Success. And I will also let you know via email when my next piece of content is out. And you can subscribe to my email list by opting into my Easy Launch Tech Toolkit. And in this Launch Tech Toolkit, I am showing you exactly which tools I use in all of my launches across all of my businesses. And after 10 years of research and trying almost all of the tools out there, I have come up with the ones that are most effective, economical, and easy to use. So save yourself the hassle and the weeks upon weeks of research and not knowing which are the best tech solutions to go with, because I've done all of the hard work for you and have put them all together in my Easy Launch Tech Toolkit. So this toolkit is part of my Manifest Your Dream Launch course. So go and grab it now for free for a limited time by going to kathkyle.com/launch toolkit. And don't forget that I am now offering one-to-one coaching at new introductory prices, and I'm putting up the price every single month. So if you're interested in me having a look at your business and how you can manifest success into your business, go to kathkyle.com/coaching before all my places are sold out this month. So now it's your turn to go and put your stamp on the world.